being part of this event and for hearing the presentation later on. We can start by sharing some information about you, your company, what is it you do in this area.
Okay. Yeah. I'm Murado Khodorov. I'm the Chief Innovation Officer of Information Builders. It's been over 40 years now in the business of information management, business intelligence and analytics. And we specialize in differentiating the marketplace by making information and analytics pervasive. That means accessible to millions of users. We have one of the largest applications in the world with over 20 million users of business intelligence and analytics. And my role is to look into the future, look into the technologies that we want to invest, develop, build, acquire, and etc., so we can continue with our core mission of making information management and business intelligence more accessible and pervasive.
So you're actually helping and assisting companies to utilize data?
No, we're developing our own technology. Yeah. So we as a company help companies innovate with data and apply technologies to data so that they can facilitate decision making in their organizations and better decision making and naturally better operations. But my specific role is how to enhance our technologies and our platform.
Mm-hmm. So how do you think companies can get ready for the big changes that are happening now in data science and analytics?
Changes have been happening all the time. Yeah. So what we're seeing, data and data-related technologies have been pushing the frontier of data, so we can get more and more data every year. So big data is not a new concept. The first big data was the first Excel sheet when people could see thousands of rows in one computer screen. Now we can have billions and billions and, you know, even more than billions, trillions of data rows. So we're constantly pushing the frontier by collecting more data. Naturally, that gives us opportunities for more analytics, but it also means that we continuously have to invent new ways of analytics to cope with the bigger data that we collect. So what companies can do is to understand the problem and, to number one, to build the technical skills and the human skills to do that. So they have an ongoing continuous roadmap about how to develop these skills and how to move into the next data frontier as we come across it. And most importantly, companies don't have to think just about data, but they have to think about how they would apply this data to better decision making. We're right now obsessed about data, but data for what? We need to make money with data, otherwise it's just a hobby. So that part is missing. The business aspect is very important for organizations.
Mm-hmm. How do you think they can actually get there and get that full potential of data?
They just have to think like business people. How do business people get the full potential of any resource? Data is a resource, like the physical resources, like factories, equipment, people. So you have to think of data as a resource, and you have to be creative about how you're going to make money with this resource. What I see most often is we think of data as something interesting, something curious, but we don't think of data as a resource, and that's a mindset change that has to happen. And we're seeing more companies adopting the role of the chief data officer, who is particularly tasked with the aspect of monetizing this data, making money with it.
What do you think is, what can we expect in the nearest future?
You're going to see a huge divide between the companies who make money with data and the companies that do not, because making money with data would secure very huge competitive advantages to those who do, and is going to leave those who don't behind.
Well, thank you so much for the interview and for the presentation later today. Hopefully with sharing knowledge like this, we can move forward in this area.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I'm glad to be here.